Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, we have seen till now what do you mean by the convection, and let us start with the convection in this topic. But before this, let us talk about few of the basics definition that are required for the convection. Convection heat transfer. Now in this, we are going to talk about few of the basic definitions which are essential to understand the convection heat transfer. The first thing in that is the convection itself. Then the second thing is natural convection. Then the forced convection, and we are going to talk about fluids. Let us start with the convection. The convection heat transfer, in general, we can say that the convection heat transfer is a heat transfer where there is a bulk motion of the fluid. The heat transfer caused due to the bulk motion of the fluid. The best example for this is the very old example of boiling of water. Let us consider that there is a water inside and we are going to heat it. Now in this case, what is going to happen? The first layer of the water will undergo conduction. So the heat will be transferred from the heat source to the first layer of the water. So this heat transfer is due to the direct contact between the molecule of the pot and the molecule of the fluid. This heat transfer we call as a conduction. Then what will happen? As the molecules are As the molecules are free to move, these molecules will have their density lower. See, the temperature of the molecule is increased. The increased temperature will in turn decrease the density, and then the decreased density will cause the buoyant force. Now, what is the buoyant force? The buoyant force will come into picture. This buoyant force we have studied in the fluid mechanics. Due to this buoyant force, the molecules will go in the upward direction, and then the void will be replaced by the colder molecules. This way, the fluid will start moving in the upward direction. Now, this phenomena they call as advection. Now, the convection is nothing but the addition of conduction and advection. So, this total phenomena can be called as convection. So, as we have seen in case of thermodynamics, there are two approaches to study any given phenomena. One is macroscopic approach and the other one is microscopic approach. Now, with the macroscopic approach, we can simply define the convection anything but the heat transfer due to the bulk motion of the molecules or of the fluid particles. And at the microscopic level, we can say that since the molecules are free to move, they are carrying the heat and they are moving in the direction at the lower temperature. Now, this was all about the convection. Now, let us start talking about the natural convection. Now, what do you mean by the natural convection? In case of a natural convection, the movement of the fluid is by buoyant force only. So, in case of a natural convection, the example that we have just seen as the boiling water, there is no other external forces which are involved for the movement of the fluid. The movement of the fluid only caused due to the temperature difference, which in turn caused the density difference, and that brings in the buoyant force into the picture. So there are so many examples of natural convection. There are quite a few examples in case of a natural convection. The best example is the heat transfer in case of a boiling water itself. Now, to describe about the forced convection, the forced convection is the movement of the fluid is due to both. One is the external force and the buoyant force. So this kind of convection, the force convection, you will find literally everywhere. So even the cooling of your own body is due to the force convection. When you switch on the AC or when you switch on the fan, you feel comfortable. The reason behind that is that the force convection has increased the heat transfer rate from your body to the surrounding, and that makes you feel comfortable. So this force convection is the convection where some external force will be applied, so such as fan or any other way. The velocity of the fluid is increased, and the velocity of the fluid will in turn increase the turbulence, and that turbulence in turn will increase the heat transfer rate in case of a force convection. So these are the basically two types of the convection. We have talked about the convection and the types of the convection. First one is natural convection, and then the other one is the force convection. Now let us talk about the fluids. Now in case of a fluid, one must understand the fluids are nothing but the substance whose molecules are free to move. So basically the liquids and the gases combined called as fluids. Now we need to understand that there are so many types of fluids. To understand the heat transfer in case of a convection, one must understand the various properties which are regarding with the fluids, the one that we have studied in the fluid dynamics. So let us talk about the types of fluids. So it can be classified as ideal fluid, then the real fluid, Newtonian fluid, non-Newtonian fluid. So these are the basic categories of the fluids which we can talk about. In case of an ideal fluid, it has no viscosity. The viscosity of the fluid is negligible. In real fluid, there will be some viscosity. So most of the fluid which are exist, they all categorize into the real fluid. Third one is Newtonian fluid, where the fluid obeys the Newton's law of viscosity, which is nothing but tau is directly proportional to du by dy. Now this is the Newton's law of viscosity. The fluid that follows this rule can be called as Newtonian fluid. Examples are air and water. The fluid that does not obey the Newton's law of viscosity are called non-Newtonian fluid. So this is the type of fluid. The other category are compressible fluid and obviously the incompressible fluid. In case of a compressible fluid, obviously the density is not constant. In case of incompressible fluid, the density can be called as constant. The best example of a compressible fluid, all gases. The all gases can be considered as compressible fluid, and all liquids can be considered as the incompressible fluid. See, why we need to study all thing about this is that we must understand the types of fluid before undergoing the process of analysis in case of convection. So in this topic, we talked about the basic definition required for the convection, such as the definition of convection itself, then the types of convection, that is natural convection and force convection, and then we talked little bit about the fluids. Now that is it in this topic. Thank you for watching this video. Please stay tuned with Ekeeda and subscribe to Ekeeda. Thank you.